Hi. I'll walk you through this example to explore solving a rational equation. Solving a rational equation involves the following steps. Firstly, find all restrictions. That means we will find all the values that make any denominator in the equation zero. These values will be avoided from being considered as solutions. So let us look at the equation. The denominators in the given equation are x and 2x. Look at the numbers, negative 3 and positive 3. They can otherwise be written as negative 3 over 1 and 3 over 1. The denominator for these numbers then would be 1 in both cases. When you see 1 as the denominator, you can ignore it. Now we look for values that make the denominators 0. The denominators x and 2x will become 0 when x is equal to 0. So the restriction will be x is equal to 0. The second step is to find the LCD of all the rational expressions in the given equation. In order to do that, we look at these denominators, x and 2x, and determine the LCD. Between x and 2x, we can quickly recognize that the LCD is 2x. The third step is to multiply the equation by LCD. The equation we have is 5 over x minus 3 equals 7 over 2x plus 3. We multiply this equation by the LCD we found. So let us wrap the left-hand side as well as the right-hand side and multiply by the LCD, which is 2x. We distribute the 2x onto every term inside the parentheses on both sides, and that would give us 2x times 5 over x minus 2x times 3 equals 2x times 7 over 2x plus 2x times 3. Now we will simplify each term of this equation. In the first term of the left hand side, we see x on the top and x in the bottom. They divide each other, giving 1. Same way, in the first term of the right-hand side, we see 2x on the top and 2x in the bottom. They too divide each other, giving 1. Now we simplify the equation that we have, and that would be 2 times 5, which is 10, minus 2x times 3, and that will be 6x, equals, we just have 7 in the first term of the right-hand side, plus the second term will give 6x. For the next step, we take that resulting equation and solve for x. You must observe that we got the denominator as 1 for every term in that equation. We will now go ahead and solve this. In order to do that, we group x terms to one side and numbers to the other. Let us add 6x to both sides so we can group the x terms. We are left with 10 on the left-hand side and 7 plus 12x on the right-hand side. Now to bring the numbers to the same side, we subtract 7 both sides. We will have 3 equals 12x. To isolate x, we divide by 12, because 12x is 12 times x. We do the opposite to get rid of that 12. So we divide by 12, and what we do to one side, we do to the other as well. And this would give x to be 1/4. As step 5, we will compare the proposed solutions to the list of restrictions and reject any proposed solution that is in the list of restrictions. The solution we got is x equals 1/4. And in the list of restrictions, if you try to look at step 1, we have restriction to be just 0. Since 1/4 is not equal to 0, we do not reject the solution. As the last step, we go ahead and check the validity of this solution. In order to do that, we plug in the solution in the original equation and look for truth. We got x equals 1/4 as the proposed solution. Let us plug that in the original equation. The original equation is 5 over x minus 3 equals 7 over 2x plus 3. We're plugging 1/4 in the place of x. And this is what we get. We take that and try to simplify it further. You must recall how to divide when you have fractions in the denominator. So we make the division as multiplication and flip the following fraction, which will give us 5 times 4 over 1 minus 3 equals 7 times 4 divided by 2 plus 3. Simplifying further, we will get 17 equals 17, which is a true statement. What that tells us is x equals 1/4 is a valid solution for the given equation. I hope this helps. Thank you.